Welcome back, everyone. In this video, I would like to show you the known leak points of a 6.4 liter Powerstroke. Then I will show the removal of the radiator. In the future episodes, I will continue with the replacement of the thermostats and the horizontal EGR cooler. Today we'll be working on a 2010 F450 in for coolant leaks. There has been many problems with repeat radiator failures caused by thermal variances in the cooling system. First, Ford had identified a cause and then had a recall to install a Venturi T in the return line to the degas bottle. Then it was identified by hyperextended thermostats as the cause of the repeat radiator failure. Now Ford has addressed leaks from the radiator hoses and they have revised the radiator hose and connections to the engine. On this truck here, we can tell that the coolant leak is from the lower radiator hose where it connects to the water pump. But you also want to inspect your radiator. As you can tell by this radiator, the cooling system was in pretty bad shape to begin with. A lot of rust residue left over. The entire end cap of this radiator is leaking. Most of the time you'll find the end that's leaking down near the bottom. Look through the fender well and you can see those there. Again, this one has been leaking for a while. Luckily for me, I noticed this. That's right, we have rust residue of coolant that's leaking through the EGR temp B sensor. That means we have an EGR cooler leaking. This vehicle has already had the hose replaced with the revised model. This vehicle once had an oil cooler failure on it, and you can tell by the oil stain, so we're going to replace that with the updated model. Okay, so let's start taking this apart. We're going to go after the radiator here. First, we want to go ahead and disconnect the hood latch and the cables connecting to it. Next, let's go ahead and loosen up our CAC hose clamps. Now you can remove the two bolts and loosen the upper portion of the charge air cooler, and we're just going to let it hang forward. Here we'll disconnect the three bolts on each side to remove the upper support. Now we can remove the power steering cooler mounting bracket bolts, and we're just going to hang the power steering cooler out of the way. Now you can disconnect your radiator mounting brackets. It's always a good idea to go ahead and disconnect the battery. So here we're going to disconnect the battery cables on the left-hand side and then on the right-hand side. With the battery disconnected, I feel a little better reaching into there to loosen that lower bolt. Now the mount comes out. Now remove the left-hand side. Okay, now with the mounts removed, just light pressure on the radiator, push forward, and the upper support will pop right out. And don't forget to disconnect the horn like I just did. Go ahead and remove the upper air deflector, and you can get the battery cable out of the way also. I use a pair of 90 degree needle nose pliers, a small pair, but it works great on removing the push pins. On each side of the radiator is a small rubber air deflector that goes between the radiator and the cowling frame. You want to go ahead and remove those without breaking the deflector. It helps keep the airflow going in the right direction. There is one on each side. The push pins holding them down, they can be tough to reach sometimes. Just try not to tear the rubber. Finally, it comes out. Now we're going to disconnect the upper vent hose from the radiator to the degas bottle. It has push pins that hold it to the upper cowling of the shroud, and then the clamp on the right-hand side. You can just lay it up on top of the engine and it'll be there when you need to put it back together. Now if you have a four-wheel drive vehicle, go ahead and reposition your vacuum line also and disconnect your solenoid. Next is to remove the shroud. There's two bolts down about halfway down the radiator. An extension will help you reach them. They are kind of tight to reach, even harder to see. Same thing with the left-hand side, one about halfway down. You have two holding the power steering reservoir and one holding the shroud to the radiator. These can be one of those bolts where you gotta hold your breath. And of course you can't reach it, but that's why I have a pocket magnet. Now we're gonna disconnect the transmission cooler, two 8mm bolts, one on each side, and the condenser, one 8mm bolt on each side. We will not be evacuating the AC system. We're going to leave it intact. What we will do is we'll just position the condenser out of the way and you'll be able to work around it. Now for the radiator hose. I should have got a close-up on this. There is a metal wire clip that basically snaps in place when you insert the radiator. You need to fish that clip out to pop the radiator hose loose. Thank you. As you can tell, sometimes they stick. Pull the power steering reservoir off the mount on the upper shroud and just position back towards the engine, and then remove your upper shroud. Here I'll go ahead and disconnect the transmission cooler lines from the radiator side. I will go ahead and put a vacuum cap on the radiator side, and I will put a cap in on the cooler side just to keep my leak to a minimum. Here's a little better view of the right-hand radiator air deflector. The little push pins kind of hold it in place, just try to not trip it. Now for the lower shroud mounts. These can be another one of those where you gotta hold everything just right. This is looking underneath the cowl towards the front body mount. And you can see the nut there, and there's my socket trying to reach it because it is tight to reach. Left-hand side's a little harder. Again, where's that pocket magnet? This view will look between the bumper and the headlight itself, and then you can see down in there is the other shroud bolt. We need to remove this one too. This one's a little tougher to reach. That should be worth a thumbs up for the one-handed video shot. Here's a great view of the clip on the lower radiator hose on the right-hand side. Now the upper transmission cooler line. Just disconnecting the same routine, I put a vacuum cap on the connection of the radiator and I plug in the hose. With the hose disconnected, the cooler sits in a mount on the radiator, so light pressure removes it. Same with the condenser. Light pressure on the condenser will remove it from the mount. With the condenser removed from the mounts, just pull a little bit on the hose, not a lot of effort, and we'll just squeak it around so it mounts in front of the charger cooler. The rubber hose will have enough flex to give you plenty of clearance to remove the radiator. Next, removing the radiator is a little easier with some help.
Grab this side, I'll grab this side. We're going to lift it up, tilt it back, and then pull it out.
Okay.
Just the radiator. Just like that.
Well, there you go, just like that. It's not too hard of a repair at this point. I appreciate all your support with my videos. Hope you stay tuned for part 2 and maybe 3. Thanks.